What the flip is up, tubers? Shut the fuck up. I get it. I suck. I know. I haven't posted in like 2 weeks. But I just needed a little mental health break. You know what I'm saying? I also think I'm going insane because of my IUD. It's a form of birth control and it's making me go insane, I think. Just because there's like a bunch of hormones in it. Really bad mood swings, and I feel like I just want to punch someone in the throat for no reason. And it just sucks. So, let's do some housekeeping. You guys, I finally have merch. There we go. There we go. It's really cute. It says, "What the flip is up?" And then on the back it says, "Remember to call your parents." And it's really cute, really fun, really fresh. Link in the description if you want some fresh merch. This video's gonna be like a get ready with me video. Oh shit, I forgot I was covering my camera with a post-it note. AKA a germ. Get ready with me. A germ. Gotta love our germs. Germs? Germs? Germs. Germs. I don't freaking know. Whatever.
Just because I have to get ready and I have so much I have to do today, might as well kill a bird,
might as well kill a bird, right guys? Let's pause this video, go outside, get a bow and arrow, let's kill some birds. Who cares? Who cares about Tanacon? Let's kill some fucking birds.
Kill two birds with one stone. Okay, I love my merch and all that jazz, but it was just way too hot in there, so I changed.
You changed! LA changed you.
But you should definitely go buy my merch anyway. So, is this too much? Is this distracting? You can't even see me anymore. Damn it. Let's just cut the bullshit. I'm gonna talk about Tanacon in this video today. Nothing against Tana, me and her were actually like kind of close last year. We were pretty good friends at one point. We're friends on Finsta, so I think that really solidifies a friendship. When you're friends on Finsta, that's when you know it's real. I see all the dirt. But I'm just gonna kind of tell you my experience with it and what went down as a person who was a creator at this event, or a talent, as you should say. I got a Insta DM. She was like, "Hey girly, I'm throwing a convention," and I was like, first of all,
what?
What do you mean? She said, "I'm throwing a convention called Tanacon." And at first I giggled, I was like, bitch, Tanacon? But I was like, all right, keep talking. And she was like, "I would love to have you as a feature creator or like a talent or whatever." I'm never invited to VidCon, and I've been to VidCon. My first year there, I had a community pass. I couldn't even afford a creator pass. A creator pass is so expensive, it's like 200 bucks or something. People really judge you on what badge you had. And that's something that I didn't know until I got there. So I get what she meant when I was watching her video about VidCon and why she hated it and like her experience. Cause people do treat you differently depending on the badge that you have. And I think that's just absurd. I think it's bullsh. I just like hate the whole status thing. I even hate the concept of people looking at me differently because I have a lot of followers and because I am a YouTuber. Like I'm no different.
Blah, 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 blah.
So I liked what she was doing. I liked her motive for this convention. Essentially, it was a convention where everyone's a feature creator. And I thought that was really cool. I liked the fact that it was free. I thought that was cool. Free. I didn't know that it wasn't free till later. I thought it was cool. I was like, oh, Tana, look at you go. Like, starting a movement. I'm down to support you. Like, I had to think about it for a few days. I genuinely, like, don't like conventions just because they're so scary. There's a lot of people running around all the time. People screaming your name. It's just a lot. Like, I don't put myself on a pedestal. So when people are screaming my name, I'm just like, whoa. I'm really not that, you know, different from you, you know? You don't have to scream. Let's just have a combo. Oh my gosh, every time I go to playlists, I have a really hard time. I stick it out because I love meeting you guys and it's really special to talk to you guys one-on-one. But I mean, just the whole event, I hate throwing around the word anxiety so much, but
bitch, I have it.
And it really comes out at these conventions. So I was really debating on going to Tanacon. I just said yes, and I was like, whatever, we'll see how this goes. I wanna support you in your first convention. I think that's cool that you're actually doing it. Cause it was all talk at first. And then she's fucking, like, she was on Forbes. She did an interview with Forbes talking about it. She had a ton of interviews talking about it. So I was like, okay, this bitch is legit. And I know she's probably taking a lot of time to plan it out, you know, because it does take a lot of planning. Sorry, I'm super sick too, so that's why I sound like a hog. Like, I literally sound like a pig. She sent me an email saying, like, do you want to do a panel? Do you want to just have a meet and greet? Do you want a live performance? And I saw live performance and I was giggling and I was like, I want to go on stage and do something. I was like, I want to perform Hefner, her song Hefner, but acoustically. I thought that'd be so funny. Hefner is just such an iconic bop. I just wanted to strip it down and really let you guys hear the lyrics and absorb the lyrics, you know what I'm saying? All these bitches out here trying to be playmates. I just want to be you, Hefner, bitch. Ayy. I was gonna have dancers and shit. Yeah, fuck on your bitch like I'm Hefner. Take time to sell like a rapper. Drop 5K on a drop of fucking water. More ice on your wrist than tuition for your dada. Like, I was about to go in. I was about to get freaky on stage. My good friend Ryan really wanted to go, so I was like, Ryan, come with me, bitch. So Ryan was gonna be my plus one, and he was. He was an amazing plus one. I'm so glad that he was there with me. So we go on our road trip. We wanted to get that car paint and write Tanacon 2018 on the back of our car and just write all over our car about Tana. Like, honk if you love Tana and shit like that. We were having fun, but we ended up not doing it because we were super late. But we get to the convention and I'm wearing my PJs, bitch. Like, I'm not trying to dress up to go to Tanacon right now. You know what I'm saying? We left at like midnight. I'm not trying to look cute rolling into Tanacon, you know? I walk in, we see Zane Hijazi at the check-in counter. And me and Zane were like giggling, saying hey. He was talking so much shit about my ID though. Because I just got my California license because I lost my Oregon license. Don't ask, it was a mess. So I went to the DMV and I failed the first time. I forget how hard the written test is, bitch. So I failed the first time and then went back the next day, passed it by one. Like, if I got that last question wrong, I would have failed again, but luckily I passed. I'm an educated guess. Like, I'm still remembering that moment and I was shaking, like sweating, sitting there, like taking that test. Looking at this last question, just knowing that if I get it wrong, I fail and my mom's gonna cry again. Yeah, so Zane was talking shit because they gave me a temporary ID because they can't just give you the actual card when you get your license. They give you a piece of paper and it says temporary ID. There's two pieces of paper, they're stapled together. And so whenever I have to go anywhere, like to the club and shit, I have to like pull out this paperwork and explain to the bouncers or just wherever I'm at about my situation. It's so embarrassing. So I'm at the front desk with Zane and Ryan and they ask for my ID and I just like instantly panic. I'm like, oh my god, fuck. So I have to like get out a fucking file, get out my paperwork, explain to them. Zane was talking shit. he was telling the hotel people that I'm like not from this country, like I'm from Slovakia. I'm like, Zane, I don't have time for this. And the hotel people were actually confused. They're like, so is this paperwork legit? And I'm like, yes, no, it's legit. And Zane's like, no, she's actually lying. Those are not real documents. I'm like, what the fuck? Anyway, so yeah, so we get in and we were all walking to our hotel room, but in order to get to the hotel room, we had to walk through the hallway and shit. So we're walking down the hallway and me and Zane are like, this is the tiniest fucking, I was like, is there any more room? Is this like the only hallway? Because it was literally just one hallway and the hallway was kind of narrow and there was a barricade in the middle of the hallway. So everyone was expected to be on one side of the barricade against the wall and then just walking space on the other side. You walk into the convention and you just see a huge sign that says Tanacon. I was expecting to see portraits of Tana all over the hotel. Like, I was expecting to see cardboard cutouts of her just everywhere, just like sticking her ass out, just like being hot, you know? I was expecting just framed pictures of Tana and like Bella Thorne and just like pictures of her like sitting on like a throne, you know what I'm saying? Just like huge ass pictures, like black and white photos of her with like boas on and like glasses and her Gucci boots, like, but it really wasn't like that. It was just like plain hallways. I was like, Tana, you could have made this so fun. Like, if this was my convention, I would have pictures of me everywhere, like Trisha Paytas style, you know? I don't know, and there was three rooms. So I was looking at this hallway, and I was looking at the three rooms, and me and Zane were trying to figure out, we were like, there's no way that this is gonna work. Like, there's no way, like, this is gonna flop, like, I'm scared. But we'll see how it is. We'll see what happens. And me and Ryan go up to our room, and there's like security on the floor, on each floor, asking for our room keys. So I was like, okay, this is safe. Like, there's security. That's really good. And we go into our room, and this shit is huge. This is the biggest hotel room like I've ever stayed at, truly. Like, it was like a suite. She really like gave all of the creators a suite, and I was like, okay, honey, like, I see you, Tana Mojo, hey. Like, this bitch really took the, and then not even that, but we see a huge ass champagne bottle on the desk, and we were like, girl, okay, like, hell yes. Not only was there champagne, but this bitch had macaroons. Like, macaroons around the champagne bottle and like assorted chocolates. Like, it was a huge deal. Like, I was so happy. I was like, you know what? Once I saw that, like, how much effort she put into just that, I was like, okay, like, this will be fine. Like, you can tell that a lot of planning and a lot of thinking went into this. I also didn't know how many people were going. I didn't know that there was 5,000 tickets sold. So I was just like, okay, this is probably just gonna be a really small, like,
chill
event. Love it already. I've got a huge ass wine bottle. I got some assorted chocolates, macaroons. I've never in my life bought a macaroon. I've never been like, you know what, I'm gonna spend $10 on this weird pastry. I don't even know what it is. I just always assumed that it tasted like Pretty Patties from SpongeBob. What? I didn't know what the fuck a macaroon was, but I had one. They're okay. They're a little dry. I was kind of expecting more. Do some have jellies inside? I don't really know. But the macaroons that I had were kind of dry. It's fine. At least if there were macaroons, I thought that was pretty cool. They just looked like Pretty Patties. So I was really impressed. I was like, you know what, Tana Mojo? I've got faith in you, bitch. Like, you better pull through with this. Like, I'm stoked. And the fact that she got so many creators to come, so many big creators too. Like, she got Shane Dawson. She got so many people. That's the only big creator I can name. She's got Bella Thorne, bitch. Shake It Up. I just want to sit down with Bella Thorne and just talk about Shake It Up. And I want to... I just think Disney Channel stars are so intriguing. Me and Ryan getting our jammies. We're catching up on Trisha Paytas and Jason Nash drama because I love both of them. And I was devastated when I heard that they broke up. Like, I was truly so sad. Woke up the next morning. I had a meet and greet at 4:30. I start to hear commotion outside and I was like, what's going on? So I look out my window and I just see hundreds of teens pouring out of the hotel, just pouring out. And they're all just kind of walking around the streets on their phone.
There were also 5 police cars and an ambulance and fire trucks and shit.
My first thought was like, oh my God, is there a shooter here? Like, I was kind of freaking out. Is there a fire? Like, I didn't know because everyone seemed so frantic. I'm texting my manager. I'm texting everyone that I know that's at the convention and no one's replying to me. If something happened, then I would have gotten notified, you know, someone would have texted me, you know what I'm saying? My manager is Tana's manager, so Jordan was obviously involved with the whole event also, so he was trying to figure everything out, so I get why he wasn't texting me back, but I was just upset that no one tried to inform me, not just Jordan, but the good times people, Tana, like, no one really knew what was going on. It was really scary because I could hear the commotion outside, didn't know why, and I couldn't go downstairs. Ryan goes downstairs and he says that it's flooded, like the whole lobby is completely flooded. No one can really move. Everyone looks like sardines. When he tells me that, I'm freaking out. I'm like, fuck. Well, I supposedly have a meet and greet in 30 minutes, and I don't know if that's still a thing. So I was texting Jordan, and I was like, please just tell me if I have a meet and greet. That's all I just need to know. Just please tell me. He wasn't responding. 10 minutes before my meet and greet, I tweet out, and I'm like, hey guys, do I have a meet and greet? Like, I have to ask Twitter if I have a meet and greet because no one is filling me in. Twitter was the ones that had told me that got canceled. So I was like, okay, sick. I had a mini anxiety attack, but I mean, I always have those at these conventions, but this one was just like, I feel so like out of control. Like, I don't know what's going on. I hear people screaming outside. My meet and greet got canceled and no one's responding to me. So I was just feeling very overwhelmed, and I know a lot of the creators were, and obviously so many of the people waiting outside. I didn't know that people were outside getting burned. Tana went on a live chat and she was kind of explaining the situation, but she was also just repeating the fact that there were 15,000 people outside and how crazy it was. And this is no shade to Tana, like she obviously, or I don't know if she knew, but she just assumed that there were, I don't know who got that number though. Like, who, there's no one out there just like counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 15,000. You know what I'm saying? 15,000 is the size of the Rose Bowl or like the Staples Center, just like a stadium like that. And there's no way. And it was kind of really frustrating me because in my head, I'm like, even if there were 15 to 20,000 people, like those people aren't happy right now. Like, I get that it's crazy that that many people wanted to come to your event, but at the same time, like those people are not happy with you because this event isn't organized. You know, it would be one thing if 15,000 people showed up to your event and you had an organized way of handling them and you had different lines, you had a VIP line, you had a free ticket line, and then having a line of people that just showed up and see if they could get a ticket at the door, you know? There was a police statement saying that there were actually just 5,000 people there. So obviously that wasn't true. So I'm just trying to figure, and I know Shane Dawson, by the time you're watching this, this will probably already be solved why they said 15,000, but I'm genuinely just so upset that they try to use that excuse to cover up the fact that it was crazy and unorganized. I'm gonna assume that she made that number up. I don't know. We'll find out in Shane's video. I was just really irked that she kept saying that over and over again. They were saying that it was gonna resume the next day, and the meet and greets that were supposed to be today were gonna be tomorrow at a different location. In the back of my head, I'm like, this event is canceled. There's no way they're gonna find another location in one night that's gonna be down for all the chaos. The next day, I wake up to news that Tanacon is officially canceled. And that broke my freaking heart. Like, I was genuinely so upset. The people were burnt, they were crispy. They were lobsters. I felt so bad. And you guys were promised that you were gonna meet your favorite creators, and then it just doesn't happen. And like, especially because this event was hyped up so much. This event was supposed to be legendary. So many people were talking about it. She was on Forbes hyping it up, you know? So like, people are obviously so excited. It could have been so successful. She did it in 1 month out of like revenge. And that's what really hurts me too, because I feel like this event could have been so well done if she waited a few months and didn't do it across the street from VidCon. And when they booked that venue, they had to have gone inside and looked around and took a tour before they booked it. They're not just gonna go online and call different hotels without actually taking a tour and making sure that all those people can fit inside. So that's where I'm kind of confused. And bitch, the goodie bags! I don't even wanna get into that. The goodie bags, honey. Like, Tana, and like, I know, and I just watched Shane's video, and Michael from Good Times was saying that she wanted to have like makeup and stuff, and she promised that the goodie bags were gonna be double the worth of the VIP ticket. So everyone was like, fuck, then I want a VIP ticket. So then they spend $60, right? Like, I get that you only had a few weeks to do this, but if you're gonna put a freaking condom, some stickers, a pop socket, and I don't even know what the there's something else. If you're gonna put that in a goodie bag for the VIPers, it's like, just postpone the event and make it good and get some good shit in your goodie bag. And I know that she's heard this, she's been hearing this, so I know this is gonna sound like a broken record, but damn, that really, like, it honestly made me laugh out loud. And I know it's fucked up that I laughed that they just got condoms, because people were actually genuinely so pissed about it. But I was just like, bitch, a condom? Some of these people are like 9, 10, 11, 12 year olds that opened their goodie bags and got condoms. If I was a parent, I would, oh my God, I think that I would laugh First of all, like, I would just think it's funny. Like, this bitch put a condom in my 11-year-old's goodie bag. What the fuck? Like, I would take the condom and use it for myself if I was the mom, which probably a lot of the moms did, and then it probably broke, because I heard they were super cheap. Yeah, so I really hope you 9-year-olds aren't using that. That shit's cheap. Just go to 7-Eleven, get a Trojan. I was just genuinely flabbergasted. Like, that is the word to describe it. I was flabbergasted at the goodie bags. After she hyped it up so much, saying that the goodie bags were gonna be so sick. There's a condom and a pop socket and vegan stickers. Bitch, vegan stickers. I really hope that all of you guys that went get refunds, but if they do try to do another event, I hope that more thought goes into it, more money gets put down to make it safer, whatever you gotta do. If she really feels like she has to do it again, just take your time, girly. No rush. When the creators walked into their hotel room, there was a piece of paper on the table saying, like, hey guys, welcome to your room, blah, 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 welcome to Tanacon. And then at the bottom in bold, it was like, fuck VidCon, fuck everything that they stand for. Hell yeah, Tanacon, we about to make history or some shit like that. And I was reading that and I was like, I really hope this works out. Or else you're about to look like Boo Boo the Fool. Like, love ya, no beef with ya, Tana, we're Finsta friends. But I was really rooting for you. And I genuinely feel bad, like, that shit sucks. When you hype something up so much. Where's that beat? When you hype something up so much, make sure that that shit ain't rushed. Everybody in line needs lunch. Some water for their little butts. Little butts, keep them hydrated. The sun will get them faded. They're tired and broke. No water makes them choke. Think about the children. Please, baby, listen. Think about the kids. Think about the kids. They need lids for their heads, cause the sun is so hot. And I know you're not, cause you are inside eating some lunch. But these kids need lunch. Get them some broccoli or something like that. They are so hungry. They are so thirsty. They need some water. They need each other. They only got each other. They're holding hands in the sand. There was no sand, but they're holding hands. Get them some water, ho. Yeah, so that's my song about Tanacon. Pretty much sums it up. Love you guys so much. Sorry, this is kind of a mess. I didn't even finish my makeup. I was just kind of rambling.
It's tuber time.
Shout out to Ambriana. I think that's how you say it. Ambriana. I don't know. Wanderlust. The 3 for the E. I don't know. Shout out to you, girly. Thanks for commenting on my Instagram pic. If you guys want to be involved in tuber time next time, all I gotta do is just comment stuff on my Instagram post. Buy my merch. This isn't my merch. Call and text your parents and tell them to buy my merch. Love you guys. Tanacon 2018. Illy.